Hello, beautiful Libra, and welcome to your message. I'm Erica. I'm a psychic medium, oracle, and prophetess. If you are new here, welcome to the High Vibe Tribe. We're a pillar of light channel. Those of you guys returning, welcome back, my loves. All right. So I have some downloads for you guys. So for Libra, I got immediately ghosts of the past. Okay, so I feel like there could be some people from the past resurfacing, okay, incoming or around this time, okay, Libra. You know, I feel like for some of you guys, this is maybe someone or right that maybe you, I'm getting like bringing closure, so I feel like maybe someone resurfaces and maybe apologizes, maybe someone from the past, or they want to just make amends with you. I feel like you're a really important person in people's lives, but I feel like they don't maybe realize it until after the fact. Okay, you are Libra, you are the justice scales, you are karma for people. I'm a Libra sun, so I have lived my whole life, and right, like that's what we do. Okay, like we trigger stuff within people to help them heal karma and bring balance. Okay, so I'm also getting inner harmony, so I feel like you are going to, like, you've been doing a lot of work, because I also got it's been rough. Like, it's been rough for you, Libra. And that does have a lot to do with the South Node being in Libra, right? Like, when it moved in July into Libra, it was like, I think a lot of, I've said this before, Libras have been, like, hit heavy with the stuff that needed to be balanced, because you guys are the balancers for the collective as well. So it's like you have to balance stuff within so you could help balance stuff without or whatever, right? Okay. But things are smoothing out for you. I'm also getting memories of Atlantis and your dreams. Pay attention, okay? So you could be getting, you know, contact, you know, messages, dreams, visions, whatever it is, information about your past, okay? And your past lives maybe in Atlantis, okay? And pay attention to your dreams. And then I started hearing this song by Patsy Cline, who is one of my favorite absolute singers of all time. It's called Three Cigarettes in an Ashtray, 222 on the timestamp as I look over. And it does speak of, it's a love song, and it's basically like kind of like a love triangle, like a third party type energy. You guys might want to look it up and listen to the words. It probably will resonate with a lot of you guys. I don't know if someone maybe puts you into a third party or if you're connecting with that somehow. Your vibration is very high, so I don't feel like you're dealing with that. I think that this is more so like similar to a lot of my twin flame collective messages or soulmate collective messages. It's, I think, for a lot of you guys, maybe someone who is maybe a ghost from the past, who's maybe been in a third party. Maybe this is someone who betrayed you and maybe cheated on you or did something, and maybe they just want to return and balance out the scales and apologize to bring forth some healing, okay? So it's going to be a little different for everyone. Then I got Let's Dance, okay? So I feel like someone could be asking you out. You could be maybe going out dancing with someone, or maybe slow dancing with someone very soon is kind of what I'm getting. I'm seeing like two people slow dancing in a kitchen. So I feel like this is very intimate. I feel like this is, I feel like it's love. It's love. I feel like it's someone where it's like you're maybe cooking in the kitchen and they come up and they turn on a love song and they ask you to dance, or they just grab your hand and they start dancing with you with no music, right? That's kind of what I'm getting, okay? But you also might be called to dance. I also got yoga. So for some of you guys, you're learning yoga, maybe getting certified to teach yoga, or you're just connecting more with your body and maybe doing yoga or stretches or some kind of, like, you know, but I specifically got yoga. And I also got Archangel Michael, okay? So I feel like a lot of you guys have been calling in and working with Archangel Michael, or maybe you need to. Okay, for some of you guys, maybe call in Archangel Michael to help shield you and protect your energy. I am kind of getting that as well. Okay, so that's what I got as far as the downloads. So for Libra, let's go ahead and see. We're going to get an alchemy card, okay, to see what is alchemizing around you in your life, whatever it is. Okay, so we'll see what comes out for you guys. All right, I am getting some kind of good news coming in for you guys. This could be something that you've been waiting on or something that you've been anticipating. Okay, Hieros Gamos, Alchemical Wedding. the drowned king. This is like Poseidon and Neptune energy, right? And then we have Aries, Mars. Okay, there is, I'm going to read this one, okay? But there is, this is what I was talking about, like where there's something here where it's like you've come into Hyros Gamos union with yourself. There's definitely Kundalini rising, Kundalini activation here. All right, I feel that you activated someone's Kundalini awakening, like, okay, this gives me twin flame energy for sure. The yin and the yang. Okay, but it doesn't have to be. It also just speaks of yin and yang energy within. Okay, but I feel that you are in a soul marriage, Hyros Gamos union with someone here, Libra. Okay, and I think that's the energy of maybe someone from the past. It could also be someone new, but has a very strong past life energy connection with you. Okay, so I just saw 555. And then the drowned king. Okay, this is like for me. Like I said, it's you know, there could be like, again, this might connect with like Atlantis, Poseidon, all of that kind of energy, Neptune. But it's like, I feel like the drowned king, it's like King of Cups. I feel like someone is drowning in their feels for you, or you're about to meet someone who immediately, like, it's love at first sight and they fall in love with you. Okay, so it could be, you know, either or both possibly. Okay, so let's go ahead and read this alchemical wedding real quick. Alchemical wedding. Where are you? Sorry, guys, this book is... Oh, here it is. Okay, 209. 209, that could be a sink for some of you guys. You know, it's a zero in between, but... But it's 2 and 9, right? So it breaks down to master number 11. So I think that's another sink for a lot of you guys. Yeah, look, see, there's the yin and the yang, okay? And then look at the wedding ring, the diamond ring here, okay? I think that someone is entering your life or circling back, and they see long-term with you, Libra. This is very twin flamey, but I know it's not going to be a twin flame for everybody, right? That's impossible, but it's... Definitely deep past life soul ties here, okay? And highly activated energy here, okay? It speaks of a ritual, celebration, and uniting, okay? To ponder, it says intimacy without sex, okay? Yeah, this is like a very high level kind of energy here where it's not about the sex, even though that's the icing on the cake, right? It's about what you guys feel for each other just by looking into each other's eyes and speaking to each other telepathically and connecting on that very high, intimate soul level. This is a sacred bond. This is a sacred bond here that you share with somebody. That's what's coming in. Okay, so it says, all hail the alchemical wedding. The laboratory morphs into a dreamlike dance floor. Oh my God, isn't that crazy? A dreamlike dance floor, Libra. And I literally channeled in your messages here, what I wrote down was, let's dance. Let's dance. You cannot make this stuff up. Okay. This is, and what do people do at weddings? Dance, have fun, celebrate. Okay. So it's all intertwined here, Libra. Wow. Okay. So it morphs into a dreamlike dance floor, and all of your allies, fellow alchemists, and ancestors are here to witness the celebration. What was once lost has been found. What was once denied has come fully into the alchemist's embrace. Okay, the work is often felt as serious and studious, but the alchemical wedding is a moment of levity and lightness. When this card arrives, it is of utmost importance to mark the occasion. Celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. Honor and acknowledge those who have helped you along the alchemical path. You have come so far. Energy radiates from the uniting of opposites and the redrawing of life's blueprint. The new form has arrived. Okay, so you guys are on a whole new level. The new form of things, life, you has arrived. Okay, and it also says what was lost has been found. Okay, so this is about, I think, someone who was lost. Maybe this is a connection that got lost, you know, over time or something, and it now has been found. Someone has found themselves. They found you. They want you. You have found you. Like, it's crazy. It's all the things, guys. You'll be back to your existential queries and tinkering ways in no time. Now the work is to revel in the miracles. Okay, this is absolutely fucking beautiful, Libra. I'm going to, let's just see what the Drowned King is really quickly. The colors, the cosmic forces, the mysteries. Let's see here. The Drowned King is on 187. Okay. All right. So that could be like another maybe number sync for you guys. 187, a number that maybe you'll see. There it is. Ego collapsing, losing face, and humility. It says if you want to go deeper with this card, watch the movie The King from 2018. And it says the power of benevolence. Definitely royalty energy here for some of you guys. You're like Atlantean royalty, okay? You stood on high seats, councils in Atlantis, okay? You could be a high priest, king, or queen. You'll know if that resonates with you. It says it's like often used as a symbol for the ego, the aspect of the self that is attached to its title, name, and identity. It is said that the Drowned King is a required phase in the process of transformation. Only through dissolving who they thought they were is the king able to become who they are destined to be. So this is about a masculine king energy who has deep emotion here, but they had to become the drowned god. They had to have an ego collapse. They had to go through ego death, okay? They had to, you know, things happened that humbled them, humility, all of that, okay? So I'm not going to read like the rest of this, but it says like through circumstances beyond their control. That's exactly what I just got done saying. Thank you, spirit. The king is brought to their bottom, to their knees. When this card appears, expect a huge blow to the ego, impactful enough that it causes one to turn their life around, prioritizing grace over greed, benevolence over brutality, sovereignty over selfishness. The drowned king is eventually resurfaces as a fully changed, benevolent being. That is someone who's coming towards you. Okay, they are someone who's gone through a deep spiritual transformation. Water speaks of adaptability. It also speaks of cleansing and purification, right? Okay, so let's get right into some tarot here, Libra. If this message is vibing with you, my loves, definitely be sure to like and subscribe if you're new here. You don't want to lose the channel. If you guys want to book a reading with me, I offer a few different types of readings, general readings. I am also a past life Akashic reader. It's a part of my light work, and it's one of my strong gifts is connecting to the Akashic records. And yeah, there's a few different options and kinds of services, so you guys will see it. Tell me about Hieros Gamos union for Libra, please. Tell me about Hieros. Okay, so I'm being guided to shuffle like this. Tell me about this alchemical wedding. About this activating deep connection here with Libra. For Libra, please. Okay, I'm getting like you guys are so intertwined. That's what this is. You guys, your souls are absolutely intertwined. You guys are like together. Oh, it stopped me, and look what wanted to come out. The wheel of destiny and time, divine timing is at play here. The wheel of destiny is turning in your favor. I'm taking that, okay? So we have the Two of Cups out, all right? And this is about someone, it's about that fish jumping into the cup, okay? It's about someone taking a leap here, okay? They're swimming towards you. They've been swimming towards you in the ethers, and now they're coming towards you in reality, 3D reality, okay? We'll say that. There's something here. Look at, see, this card. I love this card. This is like one of my favorite Two of Cups cards ever, because it speaks for me of like two people who are very, first of all, connected to the cosmos, more than likely like starseed energy here, one or both of you guys. But it's about the powerful light activation that occurred or will occur as soon as you guys see each other for the first time. I feel like this is for most of you guys, someone, it's like the past returning. That's why the very first thing I heard was ghosts of the past. Okay. There's a lot of healing energy with this. Okay. And the rainbow energy is huge right now. I like, it just keeps showing up. I keep seeing rainbows literal rainbows in the sky. So many people are, I keep seeing people post pictures and stuff and sharing about rainbows that they're seeing. And then I'm literally seeing them like this, right? They're showing up in cards, on, you know, memes, things on, right? Like, they're just everywhere. This is someone who is wanting to fill the cup here. They want to bring forth together these two cups. They feel this destined pull towards you, or this very synchronized energy between the two of you guys. I feel like this is someone who gets a lot of signs, synchronicities about you. They've never forgotten you. They can't forget you. It's that. Okay. And for some of you guys, it's just about divine timing. Look at that. Four of Wands. This is definitely, I said twin flame. Okay. These two together for me is like confirmation of that. Okay. There's the 11-11, Four of Wands. This is someone you build a home with. This is a strong foundation. Okay. And the Four of Wands speaks of engagement, marriage, unity, union, right? Like everything that this Hieros Gamos card, right, talks about, literally alchemical wedding. There it is. There it is. Okay. This could be someone that you end up having a family with. Okay. Maybe you already have children or they have children. Okay. Is someone who holds a great deal of passion. Like, you light this person up, okay? There's extreme attraction. This person sees, it's unconditional loving energy. So it's like, again, like when people say, like in a marriage vow, like, you know, for better or worse, for richer, for poorer, it's like, it's unconditional, this love between the two of you guys. It feels like someone, maybe for some of you guys, has been trying to resist this. It feels like maybe they've been trying to resist this. Tell me about the Drowned King, okay? Tell me about this Drowned King for Libra. You might be the masculine here or the feminine. I think for most of you guys, you're going to be the divine feminine. So the Drowned King, yeah, look, they had to have an ego collapse. They were trying to cling to the material realm and the 3D, okay? This could be someone who's maybe also maybe had... some finances hit, maybe tower moments, financial tower moments. I don't know. Okay. But this is someone who was holding back. They held back. And yeah, they held back and they deceived. They deceived their true feelings and emotions. Ace of Cups. Okay. Someone, brown eyes can be significant. Okay. All right. This is also for you, Libra. Your cup is overflowing. It runneth over. There's extreme abundant energy around you. And a lot of love pouring in, okay? There is some kind of big love offer here for you, Libra. But this is someone, you know, I think for most of you, like I said, that held back in the past out of fear, because the Four of Pentacles is the miser and it's a fearful energy. You know, people who penny pinch and don't spend money, right? Because they're afraid of spending money, right? It's like that example, okay? But this is someone who was afraid. They penny pinched with their feelings. Okay, they may have breadcrumbed you as far in that department, but they deceived themselves. They know they deceived themselves when it came to you and to what they felt and love. This could be someone who, you know, is like a quote runner energy. Okay, but this is someone who never stopped looking back at you and never let go. All right. And for, you know, and for some of you guys, it's this new person, maybe this is a new beginning in love here, but this is someone. This is someone I think from the, in their past, they've done a lot of healing with the ego, the Drowned King, and they maybe used to be a runner and someone that was like afraid to like give, but with you, it's like overflowing love. Okay. So either way, I think for most of you guys, this is a past person, because that's what I received as far as the channeled message, before we started. So the Fool, yeah, there's a brand new beginning here, and it's wishes fulfilled for you. Yep. There he is. There he is, the King of Wands, King of the Ego. Okay, so this King of Wands, whoever they are, is now the Drowned King. Okay, they had to go through this deep sea emotional transformation. They're swimming in their emotions for you, Libra. This is someone who holds a lot of admiration and like love towards you, feelings towards you that are very deep. They go beyond this lifetime. This is, they're feeling past lives at this point. They're connecting to that, and it's deep, 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 because it's the love they have felt for you for many lifetimes, But again, look at King Ego. He had to have the ego collapse with the, he had to become the drowned king. Okay. And that is why now this person can see how they've held back and deceived themselves. Okay. They feel like they weren't honest. Okay. So there is wish fulfillments here for you, Libra. Yes, in love, but also, like I said, overflowing abundance. Like your cups are being filled up. There's a restoration, a replenishment energy here for you, Libra. Maybe your finances have been kind of lacking or stagnant, and all of a sudden things just pick up. Things just start flowing in. Your bank account is just flowing with money. Your bank account, you know, the balance, it has lots and lots of money in it. Okay, we'll say that. But this is about your wishes coming true, Libra. Okay, this is someone maybe. And also, maybe it could be you, Libra, but this could be someone who I don't know. I'm just getting like maybe someone had a falling out, or they released burdens. Maybe for some of you guys, they may have like gone back to like with a partner or chose a different person like over you. And this is someone who is filled with deep regret and remorse, Libra. But I think that for some of you guys, this is someone who's gone through a breakup or is going through a breakup, okay, of some kind of relationship or possible marriage. All right. Again, that's not going to be for all of you guys. Just when things come through, I share, right? But I do. This person has been carrying this around for some time, okay? And this is a 10. It's completion, all right? So it brings, this is it. It's them releasing all the burdens. They have to, like, get something off their chest that's weighing heavily upon them in their heart space, okay, in regards to this soulmate connection. Hieros Gamos, this person, whoever this is, and again, very strong twin flame energy here, this is someone who they feel you very strongly, okay? It's as if like you live inside of this person is what I get. Okay, this person knows beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is something special. Okay, they are definitely making plans here. Okay, to follow this path of, you know, I want to say destiny, of happiness, of light. Okay, and I feel this is someone who's going to move. They want to move things forward quickly. Okay, but this is about you moving in your life as a victor too. That you're getting some kind of victories here. Okay. All right, but this is fast forward movement. You could also be getting a new car, or who knows, maybe this person buys you a car. I don't know. There could be some kind of, you know, long distance here. Maybe a road trip is involved. Like, I'm kind of getting that too. Okay, but this is just someone who's moving towards you quickly. And I feel that this is someone, yeah, see, past life soulmate, Six of Cups. This is someone who is feeling curious and, you know, wanting more adventure, taking a, you know, shooting their shot and maybe wanting to explore and take, you know, have adventure with you. For me personally, the Cardinals have been showing up out of nowhere. So I love that they're here again, two Cardinals. This is like twin Cardinals. Okay. So loved ones on the other side, I feel, are helping to guide this together, I think. And loved ones on the other side, I think, are leaving a lot of signs about like partnership, soulmate energy, and love. But this is definitely, and the birds also represent communication, and so does the page, right? So, but it's like you guys are each other's equals. You guys are a match for each other. Definitely children involved here for some of you guys. This is someone who has a lot of, again, I can't emphasize enough the deep past life energy that they're feeling. Okay, Six of Cups, Two of Cups, Ace of Cups, Four of Wands. And then here, look, we have the Ten of Wands. Okay. Okay, and the Ten of Wands turns into the Ace of Wands. Okay, so this is someone who is releasing burdens. They need to release maybe a burden. They need to get something off their chest, probably, that's built up over time. And this is someone, whatever it is, it's meant to bring forth this passionate new beginning. Okay, so you have two aces here. You have two aces here. All right, this is... okay, a lot of forward movement, Pat, and I feel like too, Libra, there's passions igniting within you, right? Like, it's just things I feel have been kind of like maybe slow moving Libra. Okay, and then all of a sudden it's like things just start to pick up pace. Okay, someone has their mind made up about you, about what they feel towards you, all the things. Okay. This is just, I mean, this is beautiful. This is beautiful. I'm just seeing if anything else wants to come through. Okay. I'm hearing like Roxanna and Rosanna. Okay. I'm hearing that song, Roxanna, right? You don't have to put on your red dress or whatever it is, right? Okay. So let's just see what the Island Time Wellness wants to say. Anything else about this reading for Libra? This is something that with like it's just it's taken time here. The wheel I feel has been it's been turning very slowly and I feel like it was stuck and now it's like moving again. Okay, because someone is their emotions are flowing. This is someone I'm getting like I was afraid I would lose myself, right? Because this is look at that heartbroken energy. Okay, this does speak of deeply hurt, sadness, separation, a breakup, grieving. That's the Five of Cups, okay? Kisses, unconditionally loving. Someone has unconditional love, giving and receiving affection, and falling in love. Libra, you're gonna be falling in love. Okay, but I think for a lot of you guys, this person has fallen in love, or they have love, they've fallen in love. It's just like I can't fight it anymore type of thing. Okay, this person was afraid that like they've been afraid that they wouldn't be enough for you, Libra. Like this person really sees you in a very high regard. Okay, but I also think that this is someone, like I said, who could be going through a breakup where it just wasn't enough for them. They've maybe it's just they've outgrown it. Karmic energy, that's what it does. It's always for a season and a reason, okay? But it's not meant to last your whole life. Someone frustrated in a relationship, a lack of confidence, self-sabotage, fear, ego issues, and jealousy. Yeah. Okay, so someone could be ending something very, you know, like where there's maybe a lot of jealousy, things like that. This person could also have a lot of wounds from past relationships where they have embodied this and felt this, okay? But you're not like that. Like you're again, Hieros Gamos union with self. So you're confident and secure and like, you know, practice like self-love. Like you don't get jealous and insecure and all these things, right? So I feel like this person is just like very impressed by you too, but they were afraid. So they self-sabotaged. They were afraid they wouldn't be enough and they self-sabotaged in the past. Okay. So take it how it connects with all of you guys. Yeah, look, third party interference, hooking up, temptation, dating, attraction, and flirting, seduction. This person is mesmerized by you. This person is seduced, Libra, by your energy, your looks, your everything about you. Okay, they are in absolute awe and they are mesmerized. Okay, my loves. So this is what I've got for you. This is beautiful, and this is an energy that keeps coming through for people. So you know, it really is a time of, you know, soulmates and divine union and things starting to pop off and come together. So anyways, much love to you guys. Thank you for all of your love and support here on the channel. Did I already say, oh, if you want to book a reading, it's all in the description box below. If you guys want to pre-order a clear quartz Lemurian seed crystal pendant, okay, meant to be worn like a necklace. They're copper wire wrap. This is my personal one and it's like a year and a half old since I've made it, so okay. Yours will look a little probably nicer. But they are beautiful little Lemurian crystals. And if you're not familiar with Lemurian crystals, they were left here, seated here by the Lemurians. Okay, so we are meant to work with them and they are activators. They carry ancient knowledge and wisdom of Lemuria, energy of Lemuria. So they help to open you up spiritually and activate you again even more, right? Yeah, and then I infuse light language and different healing into them. They're sound charged with you know, abundance and good fortune, and obstacle removing like sound mantras and healing with Lakshmi and Lord Ganesh. They are charged with the moon and with the sun. They're just very powerful little crystals. Okay, so if you're interested in pre-ordering one, they're meant to go out around the end of March. So they're there. Okay, I love you guys so much. Have a beautiful day and I'll see you soon. Bye.